et comme Johan, comme Johan le point là, le Spence. Nice, actually, the small gathering can always be honest. And straight away, we can speak what you want to speak. So whenever I see a small gathering, I'm very happy that I can open up and I can say what I really want to say. Because with mass, you need to generalize. The moment we generalize, we have to dilute. Any generalizing is dilution. But with a small group, you can be very specific. I'll try to propose to you theory. You can't even say it's a theory, it's a experiences. Then we will discuss and analyze it logically. How much it is true and how much it can work for our day-to-day life. First, I wanted to propose to you concepts. The title is beautiful, title Time the Ultimate Thief. Time is the thief who steals the physical health, mental health and spiritual well-being from us. Physical health, of course, all of you know, more you get aged, you will be getting aged and all the disease, all the difficulties, all the problems. So you know the physical level. Physical level I don't say much. And you know mental level, how the time steals our peace, how the time makes us stressful, how the concept of time leads us to stress. Few concepts I'll present first, then we'll analyze. First thing, there are two things called chronological time and psychological time. Chronological time, you know, based on your clock, it just moves, you know, the quantity of second, minute, or hour, or a day, everything you know, chronological, based on your watch, based on your clock. Another one is psychological. In India, we say time is measured by the word kshana. Kshana does not mean second. It means the gap between one thought and the other thought. The gap between one thought and the other thought. If you can understand this one concept, time, you can just be liberated from stress. You can simply enter into the stress-free life, because all our stress is just internalizing the chronological time without understanding. For inner world, there is a different concept of time. Actually, for outer world, there is a different concept of time. For inner world, there is a different concept of time. When we try to internalize the outer world time, we create stress in our being. Stress is nothing but internalizing the outer world time. Let us see a little deeper how we can escape from it. Actually, when I first presented this theory to a group of corporate people in India, I told them, without any technique, without any meditation or yoga or any stress management techniques, you can liberate yourself from stress. They were shocked. They said, it looks too good to be true, Swamiji. They said that this is the word they used, too good to be true. But after undergoing the program, they said, sure, yes, simply it happens. Because you don't need to do anything. If the problem is just mental blockage, almost all our stress is nothing but just a mental blockage. Misunderstanding or trying to internalize which can't be internalized. Misunderstanding between the chronological time and psychological time. Chronological time is your routine. You know, by seeing the watch, you know the time. What time you are supposed to get up and what time you are supposed to walk and what time you are supposed to come to the office and what time you are supposed to do this. You have a routine, fixed routine. Psychological time, that is what we are supposed to now analyze. It is a gap between one thought and the other thought. Kshana is measured as a gap between one thought and the other thought. For example, if you are sitting with your friend who is very close to you, with whom you feel very comfortable, you will be sitting hours together and you will not even understand the time is passing. Suddenly you will realize and say, oh, so many hours passed. Suddenly you wake up and you say, so many hours have passed. I don't know how. And if you are sitting with somebody who is boring, dull, dead, for every 10 minutes you see the watch, because the time never moves. More the number of thoughts, more you feel time is not moving. Less the number of thoughts, you feel more relaxed, more stress-free. Your mind, your being, again and again remembers about the time. Again and again the thought about the time comes to you. If the number of thoughts is more, I'll put it in the other way. More you think about the time, more you are stressed. The more you are stressed, less your efficiency. Less your efficiency, you will not be able to finish the goal, the target. And again, little more stress. Little more stress, little less efficiency. Again, you will miss the target. The moment you miss the target, little more stress. We are traveling in a vicious circle, reducing our intelligence, skills and capacity just because we are again and again and again remembering the time, even if you don't want. People come and tell me, I understand Swamiji, I know for no reason I bother. I know I have enough time to finish my target and I know I can finish it. But again and again, I start worrying about it. I just get stressed out. One more thing, getting stressed out not only affects your mind, it touches your body also. Don't think that getting stressed out is just a mental problem. It's straight away connected to your body. For example, sit in your office and just start thinking or worrying about the problems. Don't do any work. Just if you get stressed out, for half an hour, you will have a shoulder pain. Straight away, immediately you have a shoulder pain. How many of you have experienced? If you get stressed out, you don't have to do any work. Just sit and worry or think about your target or the time which you are supposed to finish. You will have a shoulder pain. Straight away, your stress is related to your health. So getting stressed does not mean only physically you are disturbed, only mentally you are disturbed. It's a disease, even the physical level. People come and tell me, Swamiji, I know that I should not bother, I know the wrong things, but again and again I get stressed out. I don't know why. Why you get stressed out again and again? Because again and again you are reminded about time. The concept of time again and again comes to you. The more number of thoughts, more time you will be remembered or you will be reminded about the time. The less number of thoughts, if you can bring down the number of thoughts, you will neither know days passing nor know the life moving. There is a beautiful philosophy which was practiced in India. The ancient time, of course, now much is lost. Reversing the aging process. They call it kayakalpa. It's called kayakalpa. Reversing the aging process means the according to their philosophy, they say the more the years pass, you should become more healthy because your body and mind is now trained how to live in the world. Now you are mature. See, according to your usual logic, in anything you are trained, you are supposed to become master of that art. If you are trained to driving, you are supposed to master that art, and you are supposed to drive without any effort. Whom you call as a perfect driver? A man who drives without any effort is a right driver. As a perfect driver, you trust him and you say he has learned the driving. Same way, the more the years pass, you master the art of living in this world. Your body and mind is ready to live in this world. So they say, the more the years pass, you are supposed to reverse the aging process. You are not supposed to fall sick, because now you know the techniques to live in the world. You are not supposed to have stress, because now you know the techniques to live in this world. You know the logic of this world. The more you grow old, more you are supposed to become intelligent, healthy, and spontaneous. What has happened? Where we missed this point? It's just because the more number of thoughts, again and again you are reminded about the chronological time. If you can change just three things with understanding, a simple understanding, perception about your body. We always think the more time moves, our body gets old and diseased. It is not supposed to be. It is not necessary that you should fall sick by getting old. It is your concept. It is your perceptions. And when I say it is a perception, we may question immediately. Swamiji, what do you mean? When we get old, we feel the tiredness. Do you think it is our imagination? Do you think it is our idea? I tell you do not know the power of your mind. I myself met a person. If any of you have been to Tibet, you know there's a place called Potala, where these lamas live. Tibetan lamas. They live there. I went to that area. Somebody told me that in that area, people live long time. For a long years they live. So I went to that village. I saw an elderly man doing agriculture job. I went near and asked him, and he was wearing a Buddhist dress. I asked him, Swamiji, I heard that you all live here for a long time. Can you say a few words about that? Can you give me some of your experiences? How you manage? He just started laughing and he told me, what? If you think I am an old man, I am a middle-aged guy. Go to people who are old. I am just 136. And he is 136. There is a medical record very clearly. He is 136 and he is working in the land doing agriculture. And he says there are people who are 180 and 250. Of course, just like you all, I was not ready to believe. Then they showed me a research report. Some of our scientists from Wisconsin University has gone there and stayed, worked with them to test and see what is happening in their body, how they are living for a long time and all those things. According to the scientist, body is same. There is no difference. Just like your body, just like our body, their body is also functioning with the same logic, same thing. Then they say there is something else, some other reason beyond body. It is not that because of DNA or anything, because there is all possible research. I ask them, what is the reason? You say something, how you live. Till the end, none of them are able to say any reason. They said, what is there? We don't know any reason. All we know is basically By nature, human beings are supposed to live for 300 years. They have a strong belief, faith, that human beings are supposed to live for 300 years. And they took me to their graveyards, tombstone. In that I saw almost everybody, 260, 250, something like that. If somebody has died in 200 years, they write unnatural death. He died, unfortunately, when he was 200 years old. And they believe the human body is supposed to live for 300 years. And the other day I was reading a book, beautiful book. Again, now scientists are coming up with a theory called our body rejuvenates and replaces itself. Again and again, our body rejuvenates and replaces itself. Every part of our body is replaced by its own nature. And they say for 300 years, our body can continuously replace itself. Body can replace itself continuously for 300 years. So our perception about our body should change. The idea, you must feel tired by getting aged, you must fall sick by getting aged, is basically wrong concept. One more thing, your mind has got so much of power, whatever you believe, it will make it as a reality. It has got a tremendous power. Anything you believe, you have got the capacity to make it as a reality. That is why people who are continuously seeing the horror movies, they see ghosts. Usually normal people don't see the ghosts. Just continuously see horror movies for 10 days. Not more than 10 days, just 10 days decide. Every night see a horror movie. 11th day you will see a ghost. Or the screen which is moving in your house will look like a ghost. Your mind has got a capacity to make anything into reality if you want. If you are continuously thinking about something, it will be given as a reality. The first basic idea of your perception of time is wrong. Your idea, the more you grow, you are supposed to fall sick, is wrong in the physical level.